You know, they still do the same intro at Sketch Night.
Yeah.
It's good to be back.
Yeah.
You know, David and I just made such good friends at Sketch Night, backstage at Lit, and when Dave got married, had kids, got a new job, he hired me to be his nanny.
Then he fucked my wife.
Live from Lapinex Theater, it's Lit Sketch Night, featuring the cast of our two-year anniversary, that's right, our two-year anniversary of Sketch Night. And it's filled with lovers and interrogators, champagne and pigeons, and of course, jokes about taxes and tourists. So now, let's meet the cast of tonight's show. We've got Brian, Aaron, Evan. Please welcome back JP, Langdon, Laura, Ross, Melanie, Linky, Nancy, in the sky, David Stopper and David Byrd. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our show. Please turn off all of your noise-making devices. You don't want to have a bad date. We proudly present Happy Anniversary Lit Sketch Night. Enjoy the show, but first, a quick word from yet another single lady in D.C.
Try that again. Thank you, everyone. My name is Cassandra Whitby, and welcome to Cassandra Whitby's Anti-Valentine's Day show. Yes, I know. Thank you. Anyway, welcome to the show, and I hope that you all are having a good time.
Cass? Hey, Cass!
Oh, one second. It's my technical director, Larry. Yes, Larry?
First off, Cass, I am not your technical director.
Okay.
I am only working this show again because I learned that my ex is dating my best friend, and I may or may not have broken a coffee pot in this Dunkin' Donuts here by throwing it across the kitchen. So, I either lose this work study job or work your show. Secondly.
Okay, thank you, Larry! Thank you! Your sales and your anger are disrupting my performance, so. Anyway, I put on this show because as you know, it was the last show. My ex-boyfriend, Ben, he came up and he ruined everything. In fact, Ben is not here tonight. Wow, that's funny. He comes to all my shows. Right, okay. This is awkward. Okay, so if Ben was here, I would tell him that I'm happy for him and his girlfriend, Jenny. They're both music majors together. Good luck with that. And, you know, hi, sir. It works better if I have a Ben, so can you be my stand-in, Ben?
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Okay. So, Ben, I just wanted to tell you that we're just never going to be together, okay? Sorry. I remember when we broke up the first time, saying this is it, I had enough, because, like, we haven't seen each other in a month, when you said you needed space. What? Then you come around and then... Baby, I swear I'm gonna too much change, trust me. I remember how it lasted for a day. I say, we break up, you call me, I love you. Ooh, 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 ooh. You called me up again last night, ooh, 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 ooh. This time I'm telling you, we are never, ever, ever back together. We are never, ever, ever getting back together. You go talk to your friends, talk, and my friends talk to me. But we are never, ever, ever getting back together. Make you stand in bed. That was you were okay. Right. So, as all of you know who follow me on social media, by the way, if you don't know, my Twitter is at CassandraDiva13. When Ben and I broke up, we had a very difficult time, and I had a lot of emotions, and he really broke me, and it just was a lot of stuff, and kind of just... We chained up, we jumped, never asking why. We kissed, I fell under your spell of, no one could deny. Don't you ever say I just walked away, I will always love you. I can't live my life running from a lie, I will always want you. I came in like a wrecking ball, I never hit so hard, love. All I wanted was to break your walls, all you ever did was wreck me. I came in like a wrecking ball, I never hit so hard, love. All I wanted was to break your walls, all you ever did was let me kiss you.
I like champagne, so I ordered it to drink. What's the big deal?
The big deal, Stephanie, is that we're not at some rapper's birthday party. Everyone likes champagne, but you can't just order it whenever you feel like it.
Why not?
Because that's how the way it is. That's the way it is. People will stare.
Yeah, stare.
Last night on John Oliver, he said that the only way that you would drink champagne is if it's New Year's Eve, Valentine's Day, birthdays, and when Henry Kissinger dies. That's it.
So because John Oliver said...
He's on HBO.
HBO. I don't care. I like it, so I ordered it. I don't see why we have to have these strict rules about when and where I can order my favorite drink.
Oh, I am so sorry, Stephanie. Maybe I should order a Bloody Mary because I like the way it tastes. And I'm at brunch and I'm not hungover.
That's great. You should do that.
I was kidding, Stephanie.
I don't want to live in a society where I can't just order a delicious bubbly drink because I feel like it. These rules are doing nothing but holding us back from being happy and who we want to be. I believe that we were born with certain unalienable rights, like life, liberty, and sparkling beverages, whatever the time or place. Come on, Judith, join us. What would you want to drink, no matter the time, place, or occasion? You know, come to think of it, I can't stand Pinot Grigio. I want a macaroni and cheese jello shot.
That's gross, Judith.
And besides, it does have to be something they can actually make at the restaurant.
Okay, fine then. I want a PBR.
Excellent choice, Judith.
Cheap beer?
Who are we to judge your taste? Waiter, bring my friend a PBR. Come on, Ashley. Be free. What do you really want to drink?
Well, I was being sarcastic earlier. I do like everything that they put in a Bloody Mary. It's like drinking an alcoholic salad.
Yes.
Oh, what the hell? A Bloody Mary does sound really good right now.
Girl! Waiter, bring this woman a proper Bloody Mary. I knew you'd come around.
This is so awesome.
It is pretty fucking insane. Whee! Chill out, Judith.
Thank you.
Cheers to freedom! Oh, it tastes so bad.
Well, what did you expect, Judith? It's old beer.
Sometimes freedom comes at a cost.
Team here at Continental Hotel really heard this firsthand, okay? Now this is coming straight from HQ.
Are we all getting fired?
No, nobody's getting fired. Well, Jonathan, however.
Wait, what?
I'm messing with you, Jonathan. Anyway, now, because of recent incidents in the news, our Do Not Disturb policy can be slightly altered, okay? Now we respect our guests' privacy, but if you have any suspicions and you want to inspect their room, we're now allowed to.
Whoa.
Yes, Jenny.
Like, if they're amassing a collection of Civil War era Confederate weapons in the room?
Okay, yeah, that's rather specific. Yes. Yes, Matt.
What if your ex-girlfriend checks in with her new friend? But you know they're more than just friends. Can you enter then?
Oh, hell yeah, you have to write that.
No, you do not. That is a prime example of what not to do.
I told you he was just a friend.
Then then why did you guys check into a honeymoon suite? Only newlyweds and prostitutes stay there.
Personal space, guys.
OMG, you are so pressed.
Okay, let's settle down. Yes, Jenny.
What if, like, a guest checks a farm animal into the room? Can we enter the room then?
Does one of our guests have a farm? You know what? You know what? Animals are against company policy. Yes.
Well, Matt brought a pig to the hotel last week.
That was my girlfriend! And her name's Stephanie.
Oh, he named the pig.
Damn!
Okay, everyone, settle down. Settle down. We're getting off track. Yes, Jonathan.
So, what if the room smells, like, really bad?
It's probably weed.
No, I mean, like, the smell is kind of like that flower that smells like dead people.
Well, depends. I guess we certainly have some questions for the guest. And we might call the authorities if need be.
Okay.
You know what? Let's just end this meeting, okay? Before we end, does anyone have any other questions?
Especially around the holidays.
Yep.
You know, I couldn't visit my family last year. I had lesions all over my body. Yeah. The doctor didn't know what was going on, didn't know what to say. Turns out, I'm allergic to soap. So there I am in the hospital with my lesions and I can't see my family. I got a niece and nephew, 7 and 4. But this year, it's different. My bags are packed and I'm on the plane and not a lesion in sight. Trust me, I checked.
That's great.
So, where do you call home?
Ohio.
Ohio, go Buckeyes, yeah?
Yeah. I don't really follow sports. So.
You get a lot of snow in Ohio?
Sometimes.
Yeah, we get a lot of snow in Minnesota. That's where I'm from, Minnesota. Actually, I think my brother sent some photos of his kids laying in the snow. Let me see what I can pull up here. Okay. Oh yeah. Yeah, that's my nephew making a snow angel.
Wow.
Yeah, he's a charmer, that one. Just started kindergarten, already has his little girlfriend he eats lunch with. Ooh, oh, there's his big sister making a snowman. Oh, here comes the dog. Look at that dog jumping in the snow. Yeah, it's a pug Doberman mix, so it's first supposed to look like that. Well, fun time. Whew. Shame what happened. Yep. It's a real shame.
What happened?
You probably don't want to know. Nifty got a frostbite. Practically lost all his toes. Check it out.
Oh!
Nasty.
God!
Yeah, they look like tiny burnt hot dogs.
Sir, please, stop showing me pictures of your nephew's frostbite and telling me about yourself and your lesions and your soap allergy. I just want to listen to my music and take a nap and maybe watch a Kevin James movie on this tiny TV.
Okay, buddy, I get it. I'll keep to myself until we land. Yep. Those are my lesions. They're like tiny gumdrops, don't they? Oh, that's a particularly nasty one. It was practically inside my belly button. Yeah, it's like crazy. You can imagine. Oh no. No. The popping. They had to get a bucket for the rest. Do you see that?
Oh my god! What the? Gross!
It's
Stewardess!
Stewardess!
Champagne. Oh!
That one out of every one DC resident is completely and utterly annoyed by a tourist at least once a day from March through September?
Oh God, not another tourist group. They're in my way!
And what about tourists who block your pathway on and off the metro?
The left side is for walking, morons!
More importantly, have tourists prevented you from making it to work on time because they stopped you and asked you for directions?
Look, the president needs this bill signed today. Every minute we waste, his approval rating is going down the... Oh God! God, there's so many of them! And I won't get their mouths out of my face! Ah, shoot!
Don't allow tourists to bother you anymore. Now, the city of DC, which has acknowledged that it is completely apathetic about enforcing any laws other than taxation and parking violations, is allowing DC residents to take matters into their own hands with days of tourists.
Excuse me, can you tell me how to get to the...
Starting tomorrow, individuals who pay property or income tax to the District of Columbia are allowed to check out taser guns from their local branch agency of Finding Unwanted Circles of Tourists, also known as FUCKED. Once you've got your taser, you're allowed to use it at will whenever confronted or annoyed by tourists.
Days of tourists, because it will make you feel better. This public service message was brought to you by FUCKED. The taser guns for the Days of Tourists program were tested on very large buffalo.
Sonic LED TV shows Game of Thrones and cuts out every time they show Daenerys. The kind of sick torture you want
to... I don't want to go to jail! But honestly, that doesn't sound that bad.
It works! I mean, why would I know? You know what? Let's bring out the bad cop.
Wait, ain't you the bad cop?
Hello, my lovelies. Oh, a nice face. And a cute one, too. Is everything okay? The temperature's all right? Can I get you anything? Tea, coffee, homemade pickle juice kombucha?
Coffee would be nice.
Oh, that's just what I've been to bring. Here you are, Gamper. Oh. You just missed a little
Thanks, but ain't you gonna yell at me?
Yell at you? Why would I ever yell at you? No! Actually, I'm going to sing to you. I got this feeling inside my bone. It's electric. You look a little tense.
Huh. And you look even tenser when you're in a jail cell that smells like pine saw. And your roommate's a big humongous guy named Brick with tattoos and he ignores you all day.
Okay, still, that really doesn't sound that bad.
Gary, Gary. I love Gary. A little scrawny, but nice and hairy. Gary, Gary, what a nice man. You'll soon find out that I'm his biggest fan.
Okay, that was weird. Can't you just try to scare me like Officer Biggs over here?
Yeah. Scare you? Now, why would I ever scare you? No, actually, I'm going to do the opposite of scare you. I'm going to make you feel real comfortable. Now come closer, Gamer, so I can give you a nice massage.
Stop! I hate people touching me! Come out!
Oh, I know you're kidding, and I'm not gonna stop until you give me a big smile.
Oh, no.
He's never gonna stop. I know from experience. Just like I know that you're gonna spend the rest of your life, or at least exactly the next 5 years, behind bars if you don't confess.
Ah, get off! I'd rather go to jail than have this creep touching me.
Oh, you're such a tease, Gamer. Tickle.
No! You mean tickle! No! No! Stop! Alright!
Isn't it cute?
Alright, I confess I did it. I pushed Benny in front of the bus. I'm just get this psycho out of here.
Fine.
Ian, get him out of here.
No, Gamper. That's not the way to treat your future cellmate now.
What? Oh, did I call him officer? I'm sorry about that. Yeah, you know, the captain gave him a sentence reduction because he helps out with confession sometimes. You know. Have fun in jail, you two lovebirds.
No!
Since leaving late.
Milan,
Rome, Brussels.
Cashing checks and snapping necks.
We are international assassins.
You know, breaking into acting's hard, but, you know, becoming grounded, playing strong characters.
All those lessons really help when blending in to silently kill a variety of corporate magnates and political oligarchs.
I mean, there's no better way to escalate to a third beat than, And, you know, we really owe it all to, we really wouldn't be where we are today without Nancy.
Nancy, yeah. Yeah, I mean, if you need to become emotionally detached from the decision to end a human life, there is really nobody better to work with.
Yeah, I mean, thanks to Nancy, I can now watch a man's soul exit his body through his eyes while I throttle him and only get, like, a little bit hard.
Thanks, Lit Sketch!
You know what I love about the late 1800s? No, not that. Yellow fever is so last century. It's the sexual revolution that's taking over the modern indentured woman's world. My husband and I are Protestants, so we've only had sex once. But now, thanks to Samuel Morse's development of the Morse code, I can keep in contact with, anyone who can afford a telegraph in their personal boudoir. And then things get naughty. Would you look at that? It looks like I have a male caller on the line. Oh, Doug. I'm not going to answer immediately. What, do you think I'm cruel? You never answer on the first beep. Or the second. There are rules. You can't make him think you want to talk to him. You have to make him work for it. I think that's enough. Let's see what Dirty Dougie has to say. Doug, do you kiss your mother with that mouth? Wait, don't answer that. Let's reply. Short, short, long, short. Short, long, long, short. Long, short, short, long. I just told him what I was wearing. Oh, I suppose I could do that. Short, short, short. Short, long, short. Short, long. Short, long, long. Long, long, long. Is it good for you too?
Ever since my birthday, and I mean, how do you ask somebody out during act? Yeah, okay, so you know when you're gushing on the top spot? Is that a sickness? Or like when you're swinging on the back heel? What are you saying? Dude, you just gotta blast the damn thing. Right, I definitely get it. I'm not old, but you know, what do you do when things start to get physical?
Oh, when you're experiencing spaghetti nips.
Let's say yes for now. Yeah. So first you upload your dad to the cloud.
My dad.
Yeah. And then, you know, you just trip a spunk into limestone, swang a bang a clang, and you're flipping the scooter on chunk day. And then I get the squish on, right? Yo, well, there are kids around here, man. You can't fucking say that out loud. I'm sorry, I guess I just need a refresher course on some of these. Some of these terms. I'm feeling kind of woozy.
Oh no, Grop, are you lifting the candy in the supine position?
Hey, you know, I'm just not familiar with a lot of these terms. And I'm sure they're the bee's knees, but... Oh no. The change is happening. I'm becoming allergic to slang. Help me, you have to keep saying it until I find one that I remember. Hooping the pingus. No, please, keep trying. Ex-wife juice. Koala crydnies.
I don't. No.
Salaza squarius. 401k. Reasonably priced condor. Condor to pizza. Outback Steakhouse rewards card. Hanging loose from the flippy flop. Garbling your narb.
No, I
can't understand you. Please. Help me, I can't understand what you're saying.
Are you nubbin, bro?
Time is hot. Am I old?
Definitely nubbin, bro.
No!
Okay.
Where's my package? Here I am, it's me, your friend!
Jeez!
What, I
Would that make you happy?
This is my home. You cannot come in.
So based on your Amazon purchase profile, it looks like you like camping. Do you want to go camping?
No. No, I don't.
Oh, I also saw you bought those cool razor, what am I saying, rollerblades last week?
I brought mine. Do you want to go rollerblading?
How do you know this? Every friend is required to memorize his purchaser's Amazon purchase profile. We want to make sure you get the most out of your new friend.
I'm so confused. Why are you here?
You ordered me. Well, Amazon Prime, it's a 2-day delivery.
I ordered a friend.
Okay, you know, do you have a name?
What would you like my name to be?
Okay, that's creepy. It's
creepy.
Not.
I'm just gonna call you Ross.
Ross, awesome.
Okay, Ross. Please leave my home.
Where are we going?
We're not going anywhere.
Wait, does that mean you're not gonna turn me? I can do better. I can do so much better, I promise. You
wanna stop it?
Twist it! Pull it! Stop it! Bump it! Twist it! Pull it!
Pass it? No! No! Pass it! Ross! It's time for stop. It's time for you to leave. I meant to order the entire DVD box set of Friends, not a friend.
Oh, I understand. You did make a mistake. Okay.
Yes.
I'll go. I'm sorry.
Did you say you ordered a set of Friends?
That's what I thought, yeah.
Yeah.
Got a delivery for a Michael Bing?
Oh, no, there was... No. No!
I'm Michael! We're your friends!
No! No! No!
So no one told me life was gonna be this way!
No!
Sometimes I wear my hair way up in the air, over on the side or down to there. I can do it in a beaver or in a stem. I'll chop it off and grow it back or dye it again. I'm setting trends wherever I go with my follicle follies. I can wash and rinse, repeat all day, I don't get tired. I look into the mirror and I get a little wired. You see, it takes a ton of hairspray to hold this all in. I might be suffering from asphyxiation. I'm a little high wherever I go. Follicle follies. Say I'm out on the town and my hair's really high. That's not the only thing. I gotta be careful if I go to light a cigarette up, or my hair might catch a flame. I just stop, drop, and roll with a lot of flair. The next week all you people are all burning off your hair. I'm setting trends, but nobody knows. Oh, look at me. I had a fit. You'll have to excuse me, I'm a little bit lit. Well, go ahead, admit it. You're thinking, well, hell, he does look pretty good. I'm just a little bit jelly. You can look this good wherever you go. Follicle follies. Let me check. Yep, I'm definitely high. Follicle follies. Ah, shave it off. Dye it red. Grow a fro. Call it follicle follies.
Chris.
Hi, I'm Sadie.
Hey, I'm what Chris is really thinking.
I'm what Sadie
Can I buy you a drink?
Sure.
Oh, God. Oh, God, my hand's sweating. Oh, God. Oh, shit. I'm totally screwing this up. Oh, God. Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. Did I say my Pokemon game earlier?
Your hand is literally drenched.
So do you work around here?
God, beer is so good. Just, I bet that's what God drank before he needed water.
Yeah, just down the street. I work in marketing. How about you? Please have a job. Please have a job. Please have a job.
Just across town, a law firm. It's pretty boring stuff, actually.
Did she tell me what she did? Did I forget? Does she have a job? Yes, he has a job. It's a love one.
3 hours later.
You have something in your teeth.
I really like you.
Oh shit! Did I say that out loud? Fuck! Oh God, I really like her so much.
I really like you too. You seem clean enough.
Maybe I can get your number.
I'm so sweet right now. I'm definitely getting this number.
Sure. I can definitely change you.
Years later.
Hey, babe! I can't find my watch! The hell did she do with my watch?
Sorry, honey. I set it in the drawer in your nightstand. Why the fuck did you leave it lying on the couch last night? It's a $500 Rolex, not a fucking pillow.
I found it, thanks. Rolex is kind of a funny name. It kind of sounds like Rolo, like the candy. I wonder what came first, Rolex or Rolo? I think it was the candy.
Sure, no problem. I think Betty's thinking about fucking Rolos again.
Shit, now I'm gonna clean underwear again. Do you know if I have any clean underwear anywhere? How is all my underwear always dirty? It's always dirty. I wash and it's dirty. It's like there's some sort of underwear fairy that just comes and makes it all dirty.
Sorry, babe. I don't think so. Are you literally incapable of doing a single thing for yourself? One single thing.
Never mind. I found a clean pair. I'll just wear yesterday's.
We are definitely not having sex tonight. Great job, honey. I'm so proud of you.
3 more years later.
Talk to a lover, but you worked in the same room. You've tried everything. You've tried shouting.
Hey, you! Would you possibly enjoy doing unspeakable acts?
Whispering amongst the townsfolk.
Oh, heavens no!
Hoping that someone would invent some sort of magical wire that might transmit your voice across wide distances. Until now!
What?
With sexting pigeons, transmitting lurid notes across wide distances is easy!
Uh,
naughty messages right to their intended target.
Today's focus group. My client is very interested in your opinions concerning the packaging for products that are geared specifically towards women. Now, before we begin, are there any questions?
I have a question.
Before I forget, you will all be receiving your complimentary Panera gift cards as you exit today in appreciation of your time and attention.
I don't have a question anymore.
So I'm going to tell you, I'm going to show you some product mock-ups for products that are currently in development. I'll tell you a little bit about the products, but please remember, our focus here today is on the packaging. The question is, how likely are each of you to pick up this item at the store based on the packaging?
So you don't want our opinions on the actual products themselves?
No, another market research team has already gathered that feedback. We know you'll love these products because you already told us that you want these products.
Ah, great. Can't wait to see them.
Let's begin. The first product category is clothing. So we've enhanced the front graphic here and add a little bit more color to make the item catch your eye as you walk by. Let's see. You don't have to live with that swampy feeling down there anymore. Presenting perfect panties, now with crevice flaps. Anyone at all? Just go ahead and say. I know, it's a bit shocking, but research actually showed that women prefer this shade of purple.
What the hell is a crevice flap?
You know, I think it's like a zipper fly for women. All right, let's put this one on the back burner for now.
Okay.
Now, this next product is from the client's line of skincare products, okay? So what we did here is we added some color to the text to make the box pop on the shelf. Acne. It happens no matter your age. Vanquish those pesky pimples with the Facial Discharge Squirter.
Gross!
Ah, initial reaction. Who was that? Is there too much red on the front?
No, it's the name. Squirter Discharge?
Thank you for that gift, but remember, we're here to talk about the packaging itself.
What does it do?
Let's see. Liberate your pores and let the pus pour out.
Ew, stop.
Okay, I think I see what's going on here.
I should hope so.
You should be able to tell what the product does just by looking at the box. The marketing department really dropped the ball here.
What? No, it's not the box or the product. It's the words. The awful, terrible words.
Please, I assure you that high-level committees approve this language after significant research and many layers of approval.
There is no way that women approve that disgusting language.
Really? Then I guess you're calling Martha Stewart, not a woman. Because this next product is from her line of kitchen gadgets sold exclusively at Macy's. Interested?
She is the original homemaking maiden.
No one understands a modern woman like her.
That's the attitude. Let's see. So with this box, we actually enlarged Martha Stewart's face to make it easily recognizable on the shelf. Most bread makers on the market are easy to use, but leave you with bread so dry that it's practically a giant crouton. But now there's an alternative. Introducing Martha Stewart's Moist Maker.
That's it. But their gift card isn't worth sitting through this. And I don't care what that overachieving bitch says.
Running and I'm not going anywhere, and my mother's there and she's telling me I'm never gonna make it.
You know, it seems like you think that you have achieved the goals that you believe your mother had for you in your life. that you feel like you're letting her down.
This is weird. When they said that the Disney cruise had free therapy, this is not what I was thinking.
You need to forgive your mother and be confident in the choices you made in life. You're a strong man, Chris. You just gotta believe in yourself.
You're right, Nikki. I am strong.
Don't forget to come to the Disney Family Jamboree, 7:30 after dinner. Hello!
Show! give it up for Lit's executive director, Nancy Safavi.
Please give it up to David Berg in the booth for helping us out.
That is exactly the job.